it's Emma from Abel here. Recently, I was really lucky to spend a week in Avoca. The deal was I would work remotely for 3 days, which is what you're seeing here, a very animated Emma talking with her hands even though her camera is switched off. And then I would take 2 days off to enjoy a long weekend with my family, exploring the surrounding area, doing painting and all that fun stuff. What I loved about this arrangement is that even on my working days, I could take my lunch down to the beach and soak up the sun and salt air. Views like this just put my home office to shame, so I was definitely going to jump on that opportunity. Avoca is a relatively quiet town, and I don't think there's too much to do here compared to other beachy suburbs on the Central Coast. But it's so beautiful, so if you are looking to just reconnect with nature and take it easy, then it's a really great holiday spot. When I got back from lunch, I was immediately drawn to the backyard. There was just like a cacophony of noise. So many lorikeets, cockatoos. This kookaburra in particular was causing quite a bit of noise. But there were also bunnies and bush turkeys too, which were all really, really cute.
Bunnies. And the bird scared them away.
It was so nice out here on this particular afternoon that I decided to grab my laptop and work outside for a few hours. I stayed out here pretty much until my laptop ran out of charge, and then I was able to just move back inside. I'm so grateful that the nature of my work allows me to just work remotely. Obviously, it's always handy just day to day being able to work from home a few days a week, but it's times like this where I really appreciate the flexibility. I've always loved Australian animals. I mean, I think we're so lucky to have such a unique variety compared to the rest of the world. But in particular, this trip gave me a newfound appreciation for some of the native birds we have. It was so nice to have their songs be the backing track to this holiday. After each workday, my sister, dad and I would go for walks along the beach, and then we'd always head back into the apartment to cook dinner. On my first day off, my sister was still working remotely, so I took the time to go down to the beach and do some sketching. I knew from the get-go that I wanted to use this holiday as an opportunity to get back into the painting, because I'd had several months off at that point and was just feeling so rusty. First, I started off with a few thumbnail sketches. Sorry if the footage is a little overexposed, by the way. It was really bright that day and I had my sunnies on, so I just didn't realise at the time. Here you'll see the scene that I decided to paint. Usually I micromanage my paintings a lot with digital mock-ups, and then I print out the sketch and trace that onto watercolour paper. But I wanted none of that here. This painting was an excuse to be loose, have fun, and just go with the flow.
Thank you.
hindsight, it's clear that I got the proportions of the mountains in the background wrong. In my drawing, they tower into the sky and are quite prominent, whereas in real life, they were quite far away and therefore sat closer to the horizon. When I eventually noticed this, I was a little sad at first. Like, it felt like a rookie mistake, and it almost made me question the point in even continuing the painting. But I snapped out of that mentality pretty quick and persevered, because painting is meant to be about creating and having fun and not just the perfectionism. The next day, Cathy also had the day off, so the three of us decided to go do the Booty Coastal Walk in Booty National Park. I've done this walk before and it's just as beautiful every time. There are some sections of boardwalk, there's some walking along the sand, which I'm not a huge fan of when I'm wearing hiking boots, but if you're happy to just take your shoes off and get your feet wet, then it can be really nice. And then the walk does trail inland a little bit as well, so there's plenty of variety. We saw quite a few animals on this walk. We saw some yellow-tailed black cockatoos, plenty of lizards, a couple of butterflies like this one, but there was one animal that stole the show for me.
There's an echidna.
After this, we did spend a few more days in Avoca. We just did, a couple of walks, enjoyed our time as a family, but before too long, it was time to head back home, unfortunately, but that's okay because I had some time to then go back and finish this painting. Because I hadn't done any mock-ups of this painting, I wasn't feeling very confident, to be honest. Yes, I did have reference material, but trusting myself to execute on it was pretty hard. That's why you'll see me work in a lot of light layers, slowly building it up. That wasn't necessarily a deliberate choice at the time, but it kind of just became apparent as I was watching this footage back. It's almost as if I was too scared to be bold in case I overdid it or made a mistake. I don't have much experience using these watercolour paints either. Usually I'm a Daniel Smith girl, and I have a very good understanding of how to use those paints to get the results I want. These watercolours are my Winsor & Newton pans, and I have almost no experience using those. In fact, I think this is my first full painting with them. I am glad that I pushed myself out of my comfort zone with this painting, both in my decision not to do too much planning and just go with the flow, but also in my decision to try these new, in air quotes, paints. I think it's easy to get comfortable with your standard workflow and just stick to the things you know, but in art, as with life, you do learn and grow a lot more when you step outside of your comfort zone. And that's why I'm happy I, you know, went this path. I do realise that it was a relatively small step outside of my comfort zone. Like, I didn't do anything groundbreaking here, but for me, as someone who can be quite harsh on themselves and often sweats over the small stuff artistically, this was an important exercise. In the end, even though the proportions are a little bit wacky, I'm quite happy with how this painting turned out. It's my little postcard from Avoca, and it brings back lovely memories of this holiday with my family. There were so many beautiful sights in Avoca, and I took so many pictures that I've basically got reference photos coming out of my ears at this point. Being out in nature kind of inspired me a little bit, as cliche as that sounds, and I'm thinking of starting a series of paintings on Australia's national parks, where I'd basically go out and paint on plein air just to reconnect with nature and then showcase the beauty that we have in our own backyard. I'm not sure how practical that will be for me to execute whilst working full time, but I'm keen on trying at least a few of the local walks. All right, we're nearing the end of the video now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this travel and art vlog. Have a wonderful week, and I'll see you next time. Bye.